scale it, keep you guys from having to draw this over here, so I just got all the sizes of it, and what we're gonna do is just kind of roughly measure which one will fit your hand. Now, you normally use a tape measure, measure the wrist, measure how far you wanna go down, straight line, you can see that line right there. But it doesn't mean that it's capable of water, we have a limited amount of time, so I pre-printed some out. If it doesn't fit you exactly, at least you have a template you can take home and scale it to yourself. So this is a Batman style gauntlet. What this you're gonna do here, this is a template. It's a very easy one. You can cut these out, transfer them to a piece of foam, and then we'll go from there. That's basically how it is. You just cut it out, put it to foam, and we'll go from there. This piece right here, this is the actual gauntlet right here. This is a two-piece template. So this is your main piece that goes around here. Then you cut the insides out, and this will put, we'll transfer this to a thinner piece of foam. This is the part that goes on top of that, kind of gives it a little bit of depth. And then these are your blades, we'll go right here down the middle. And these are your little straps, we're going to use the Velcro straps to attach it to your arm. Very simple, it's nothing, you know, too high tech, you know, no holes or anything crazy. Something very simple we can knock out in that and that. And then I'll show you very quickly, I brought some gesso with me to show you just how I apply it. We don't have enough time to do it all that, do painting and all that because we're inside. But just give you a quick idea of how I do things. I got different sizes right here of all the gauntlets, so feel free to take one of these sheets. And I'll start opening with the foam. If it's too small for you, I got bigger and smaller sizes over here. So my head, I have 10-inch hands, so I know. The 100% ones, I put 100%. So this is your wrist right here. This is your wrist, this is your forearm. So. Normally I would have a tape measure. This is going to be a little large for you.
Yeah, I figured that.
This is 100%. You probably want to go like 80%, which is right about 85%. Try that one. Maybe even smaller, maybe 1.75. It might be a little tight. But this is a template you can take them and you can scale it up. These are, all it is just straight lines. So there's nothing too hard to scale up and get a large for it.
Okay. Do you want me to make mine to match yours so you can have two if you want?
So feel free to pick one. If there's one that's too big or whatever, like I said, this is a very easily scalable one. You can always just scan it in and scale it down, scale it up.
80%?
Yeah.
Is that,
Actually,
that's something about. Oh,
okay. That might be a little tight.
That's a little tight.
Yeah, that's 75 is to 85, and I also have a 90 and 100. So.
Let's see.
Get two of them.
No, it's just one. It's one thick piece of paper. I'll put it on real thick.
Can we get another one?
Absolutely. I printed about four or five of each one, so okay. Take whichever one you like. Also, this is a workshop, so it's a $5 charge if you want to cut into the foam. It's basically for the con to cover the cost of the foam. So if you want to participate, pay the guy in the red shirt $5. Yeah. It's just to cover the cost of their cost of covering the foam. This is the foam I was talking to you yesterday about.
Okay.
This is stuff you can get some. I think they got this one. I think definitely got this one.
Oh, that means it'll be cheapest.
Yes. They do.
That's the best
way. They do four sheets. I think some people do six sheets.
There you go.
How much is a package?
Between $15 to $20.
Change for 20.
So for four sheets, you can tell it's a big sheet. One sheet will get you.
Right, you can get a lot of that.
We're all going to get one sheet.
Right. So the primary frame, this part is going to be cut out by that material.
Correct.
Absolutely. The inner part is going to be cut out.
And these as well.
Right.
You guys want these to become thick. The straps and the
inside
outline.
Three, four.
I have a 20,
but I got changes.
Predicted that.
Ta-da. Okay. And I think you better want to count it out just to make sure.
Oh, that's cool. Yep.
Okay, cool.
Are you two?
So I brought my barge because we're trying to
leave it too much.
Nicer.
Okay, how much do people lay out?
Yeah, I got some masks and I got my paper mask. I don't want to use too much, but I'll show you how I use it and how quickly how much better it is than hot glue. I brought a whole bunch of hot glue guns, and we'll probably use hot glue for most of this because it's not something that's going to be too taxing on us. You don't need a whole bunch of structure. So we're using Velcro. So like I said, it's a simple design. Is it okay if we take pictures?
Yeah.
I'm also live streaming this right now to my Facebook page, and so y'all should be able to go back and look at it and watch how embarrassing that is.
Actually,
well, I
can't watch it.
Whatever. I'm going to talk about this page and put it on there. Also, this is actually just like the thinner stuff.
Here's a harbor.
I didn't know Harbor Freight sold this stuff. This is about a 3/8 inch. Sometimes you'll see it at 5/8 at other places. So if you pay, go ahead and grab one. You guys get two. Now I told you it's like a little puzzle piece. This part here, you can always take off. Pull it off. I keep all of those at home. I have a whole pile of those.
Just
little
collect them.
Well, because there's so many things you can use them for.
You can make an awesome dragon with those.
You can make a whole lot of cool stuff. Yeah. I use them for like spying archery. Probably should have printed more. I am freakishly disproportionate, I guess. Yes. Grab one of these and grab one of these. And if you were over with this, but see, this is a bad one. A hole like that.
Yeah.
That's a manufacturer.
We haven't grabbed
it. Sure, go ahead.
More brush bone.
Another thing you can do is just use one hand and wrap it around your wrist and see how you get an idea of how big it is. Like Noah said, normally we would use a tape measure. You can measure your wrist where you want to bend it and the forearm where to start.
Yeah.
Just draw a straight line. That might be a little tight. Which one is this? That's the 75. I would say try the 85.
Here. That's right. That one's just about an inch too large.
Okay.
So 75 would be.
Even if they are too large, you can always add in extra pieces of foam inside, because really tight gauntlets, especially my killer product, I made them a little tight because I wear a muscle suit, and after about 4 or 5 hours of running, the wrist will just hurt.
Yeah, that one's just a little bit.
You need like 80%.
Yes, I do. That's unfortunate.
I would say take an 85, and we'll put some extra foam in there.
Okay, I guess I do.
That's,
I have a little spare for the pile that I have.
Say what?
Right, because they're supposed to be.
It's just one, and this, I'm sorry, grab that. And this is the extra, the blades and the straps. That one's pretty large. Let's see, what you want to do is take one arm, as you can, like that. So you about maybe a half inch, let's say another half inch larger than that. Just take your hand and go like this from here to there. Go like that. So you can see how much larger it's going to be. You want to go probably like that. That's the smallest one I have, so that's going to be still a little loose on you, but it's really comfortable. Like I said, you know, these are easily scalable at home. You can always come down and scale this stuff. Trying to make the easiest design I can possibly make. If you want to cut, this is an additional workshop, so it's an additional $5 that they give to the guy in the right back there.
Okay.
And you come back, I'll get you everything you need.
Alright.
Just speak up?
Yes.
No, no, thank you.
Okay.
All right, my name is Jason. I go by Titan Cosplay. I usually wear like larger costumes. That's it here. And let's see, how's it for this? That's probably, that's pretty hard for it. So this right here is the main template. I'm going to tell everybody how to cut it out. This is your extra piece. This is the Batman style. There you go. And there's that. And we have, oh, I'll probably need knives. And this is going to take where you might need to share. It might be not enough. But I brought some extras. I did bring some extras. Now, the thing they didn't think about is cutting. You're going to cut through things. You're going to probably score or damage whatever you're cutting underneath.
Yeah.
They didn't provide us with anything. Okay. But we do have some extra mats. So we're probably just going to give you a nice extra mat. You can just, I'll put a couple mats up here. So you can bring your thing up here. I'll show you how to cut it. And you can cut directly on top of the mat on top of here.
Excellent.
So don't damage it.
Ooh, yeah, it's already in there. Ready to go. Green jumps.
Everybody get the knife? We had enough?
Did we have enough?
We'll use this as a cutting. All right. Y'all can come up here, look at me, and watch how I do it. Y'all can cut up here as well. Y'all can use the ground. I'll give you an extra piece of foam. You can cut on the ground. Fortunately, there's not enough tables in here for us to get a whole lot of table space.
That was the name that they provided the tables. Oh, well.
You got to work with your work. Yeah, work with what you got.
Just be careful.
Yeah, just be careful.
Many strokes and light power.
Yeah. All right, before we all start cutting, I'll show you what I use at home to get a nice clean line. I brought a couple extra straight edges here. You know, metal straight edges, of course. Number one thing is safety. We're using sharp knives, hot glue. Don't hurt yourself here. I won't get in trouble, but someone else will. So right here, this is the number one thing I use a lot. It's Logan Foamworks. I got from Amazon. I got the entire kit, which cost about $100, and it's these pieces right here. They sell a standard kit for like $40 over here. For some reason, these are more expensive. I don't know. It comes with a 3-foot ruler. It has a straight edge on one side, and it has this little interlocking piece right here. And I don't work for these guys. I'm not promoting them. I just love it because it makes everything so much easier. But all of these add-ons have that matching lip. And just slide right in there and slide. These right here have a little lip. And slide. But these are pressure-activated knives, just like what you're using right here. But these press down so there's a little more safe. You don't make too long of a cut. On the back, you have a height gauge. So if you're trying to cut something really thin, you can set it to be thinner. If you're cutting really thick, I forget how deep it goes. It goes up to half an inch thick. So sometimes it's not deep enough. Then you have a 45 degree cutter, which is perfect for those nice clean angled edges.
Same for your brick.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, this is what I use for my brick. My which I left at the table. Also has a height change on it as well. Then you have little certain type of rounding cutting tools. And then my favorite thing is getting perfectly cut circles. This is nice. It has a little pressure point. You push down, you set your thickness of the blade right in there. Your diameter. All you do is just screw it down. Screw it all the way up.
That's awesome.
You set it down, and then when you screw it down, it brings the sharp blade. Makes it perfect. My only complaint is the blade's not thick enough. It needs to be a little bit thicker. No, it doesn't actually move. It's just the blade is set to the actual cutting surface is like an eighth of an inch. If it had a larger cutting surface, the blade would last longer. But this is a heavy set. And they also have these little hole punches right here. This is a little sharp piece of metal. Basically, it's smooth on the outside, but the inside is tapered in to be a sharp cut. And it has different sizes. And then at the end, after it pops it from out, of course, it's not thick enough. So this is what I use to get nice clean circles, clean cuts, work out your angles. It's smooth, it's nice, it's something easy to work with. It's relatively inexpensive and it's on Amazon. It's on Prime also today. So that's what I use at home. What we're going to use here today is this utility knife and straight edge. So be a little more careful. Straight edge in case you guys haven't used.
We have a new one here.
Oh, we do? Oh, sorry. I saw you there. You look familiar from yesterday. So here. here. I think it's 75. Alright, so I'm sure y'all know the basics of straight edge cutting. I'm sure y'all cut stuff before, so I'm going to go over that. This template itself is the simplest one I could find and make, just for the time constraints we have. You can go, this is a very, very basic gauntlet. You can go, gauntlet's probably the easiest thing you can make because you can do it yourself. It's easy to measure. You don't need somebody else to help you measure it. This one here, it's heavy. You have the outer piece. That's going to create your base, the wraparound. And this inner piece, this little part right here, we're going to cut that. After you cut this out, cut it out, we're going to cut this middle part out, and all you'll be left with is the negative right here. That's, we're going to cut it out of this thinner foam, we're going to put that on top of the bigger foam. Gives a little bit of depth. We'll glue it on with hot glue. We might get some barge and glue it on, so I can show you the difference. And then we're going to cut your blades out of the bigger stuff here, and then your straps out of the thinner stuff. Everybody got that? Big template out of here, a smaller off of there, blades out of here, and the straps out of that. Sound good? Mm-hmm. Now, the straps, they're real small straps. You're going to hot glue one side to, like, say, this part here. You're going to hot glue here, and I brought some Velcro tabs. We're going to hot glue two Velcro tabs, and we'll put the other Velcro tab on here. Fix it just with Velcro, put it on, Velcro on, and you're good to go. Super simple. Any questions so far? It's pretty easy. It's a very basic course. I know that some of you probably have made props and other things before, so this might come off a little too simple, but this is, I'll show you what I use. I was going to rig some Saran wrap and show you how to make a more of a custom gauntlet like I did here. This is what I use to make my Killer Croc. So this is, I took Saran wrap. This is very cheap, I think. Saran wrap, just wrap around your arm or any body part or anything you want to have a measure. Saran wrap, then you use duct tape. I prefer white duct tape because you can draw on it. And what you're doing is, I did this on the muscle suit, so this one actually doesn't fit me. But you put duct tape all the way around, and you create this mold-ish. You got another one? Okay, I'll have one. And then all you do is just cut straight line down. And then when it comes together, this was one piece, so it has a little bend to it. These are called registration marks. You just cut a little V-shaped notch. And then from there, you can lay it flat, and then you can draw it on your phone, and it'll be a perfect match. It's easy, it's cheap. A lot of people do this for like full body suits. I did this for my helmet right there. I did this method on my head. My wife did it for me. She's around here somewhere. She had a lot of fun. She had a lot of fun doing it. She wrapped my head and put duct tape on my face. So that's super simple method. I don't want to go cover that. That's too easy. So we're going to do this. And we have a little bit of space. We got a couple hot glue guns. We got some pins to help you, once you cut these out, lay them on here. I like to use little pins to help hold them out. Boom, boom. You can use, we have markers. Mark your stuff, take the pins out, remove the template off, and you make the cuts. You can use tape, but I usually don't like putting tape on your foam. You can leave stuff or you can damage your foam, whatever. So pins are pretty easy. Pin, knock that. Any questions so far?
Are we planning to use the rough side for the outside or the inside?
That's up to you. That's how you want to do it. Like I said, you have one textured side. Now, this is Harbor Freight, so Harbor Freight has a different texture than other people. Most people have that metallic grate kind of look with different marks on it. This is foam, so you can always sand this down if you wanted to take the time to do that. I don't. So a lot of people will use this so this is actually pretty cool looking, it has a little bit of a carbon fiber look, there's a leaf pattern to it. So a lot of people will use this side for like armor, to make it look like there's a carbon fiber side to it. That's all of what you're trying to do, what you're trying to accomplish. Me, personally, I have that rod with me. I got this roll here from TNT Cosplay Supplies.com. It's a Dallas-based cosplayer ran. Cosplay supply store online, and this is a double-sided EVA foam. This comes straight from the manufacturer, so it's not pre-packaged like this. They just basically put it in the bundle for you, and that's good to go. This is 8 feet. I got it for about $25, $30, I think. So it's the same width, but it's about a lot of these. But it's double-sided smooth. That's the number one thing. It comes thicker, and I think this is one of the thicker sizes they use. They have all the way thin, something like that, where I think that's 8 mil. I'm not sure how many rolls this is, but this is actually 2 rolls in one. double side smooth, you don't have to worry about that texture pattern on one side. So I prefer this. There's also a store called the Foam Store. It's here in Houston, somewhere close by here, I think. They sell giant rolls of that. Thicker EVA, 200, 300, 400 we're going to use. So if you want something massive amounts of it, I would contact them. So other than that, let's get rolling. I don't want you guys to stick your tool on. Now, like I said, cutting spaces are limited. So what I'm going to do is give you an extra piece of foam. Y'all can sit on the floor right here and do it. Y'all can cut on the table right here and do it. This is just to pick the floor and the table. So I'll just put all those out there. Put those out there. So. You don't have a piece of foam yet, so.
You need pins.
Straight edges.
Straight edges. So, once you open them up, they're just going to leave all the pins, like the 3 minutes of planting, because they're going to be here. I would say take about 5 and 10 of them. Your space is just going to hold your template to the foam.
Which side are you doing, top side, or does that really matter?
You know what, he's got a cool idea. I like this idea. I would say, since,
I want to
think about
it. Because I want to try to see if I can technically do.
You can. There's enough. You can. There's enough foam here to make everybody can make two from one. Yes. Now, what I think your idea is. Here's what I'm telling you. This part is going to be open up.
Right? Yeah.
So this is going to be on top of this colored foam. I'll be on top of this one. But since you'll see this, this kind of carbon weave look will look pretty cool from here.
On the outside.
Yeah, it'll be on the outside. So I would suggest this is kind of cool. Is cut your main template from here on this side.
That's right.
Okay.
Did you get that piece of foam?
No, I got it. Fine.
Cool. Oh, that's okay, it's right here. See, how big is your rest?
No idea.
Let's see here. Okay, so pins are right here. Face was all to throw those. About that size. Looks like you're probably about to get nice. Yeah, this is how I quickly do it.
Do you want to try to cut both of ours from
the
back piece and then have this whole piece to play with?
Come over here.
Well, my idea being.
So it actually is a little too big.
Both of us could make two each. You know, that you have actually a pair.
That's another 90, I think. That's right.
So.
That's
so. Where's the best place to pin this?
See, now this is going to be a little bit tight, but
it's on the line because you're marking it.
Somebody you don't have really good form.
So each of the points.
Oh, you got one piece of paper, basically. That's your main tip. This is your blade.
Right here. What do I pin it right here?
Now, what you got to do first is cut that template out because this is the actual thing.
Oh.
So you have extra excess stuff here. So what you want to do is use this as a cutting mat. Take your straight edge.
Okay.
I take all the straight edge. We'll use this one. All the way around. Now this is supposed to be, for some reason, it didn't print out. It's a straight line across.
Right.
So we go like this. You just keep going around, keep making cuts, and all the way around, and then that'll be your main template. Then you can transfer that figure. Of course, I like to bring it up straight edges, so you can eyeball it in one cut. You not live streaming anymore?
It's live streaming right there.
Oh, there you go. My bad.
I am a photographer who can multitask, okay?
You know, it's funny. I went to a Buffalo Wild Wings. I saw your fantasy football shirt. My wife and I went to a Buffalo Wild Wings earlier this week, and there's a fantasy football
draft
going on. I'm like, that's a Comic Con.
Yeah,
what they're doing is a mini Comic Con. They were getting loud and raunchous. I'm like, that's a Comic Con.
I got.
They're wearing like their team shirts. I'm like, they're just wearing anime hats and like Dragon Ball Z shirts.
I've got a job after this, and then I got my draft.
Only brought five. So we can share this one.
I'll just share with you.
Thank you.
I'll
give you one. Thank you. you might use a straight edge. I have a pair of scissors. You might be able to cut your template out.
And when you do your first cut,
if you wanted an extra piece of foam to cut on top of, so you don't cut the part.
Yeah, we have.
You do have that? All right, cool. Does everybody have a cutting knife or some kind of cutting?
No.
I got more here. I got exactly one. This is my first. Still fits what I'm doing here. This is still attached. This is a template. You're not actually making anything from this. You just need to have a template. So we can get one. See, that part's still attached. When we transfer this over, we'll just be nice and careful here. Yeah, because for some reason it didn't print that line. I don't know why, it just didn't print that line. That's a straight edge. Or you can make it something you need just one.
So, trim this part out?
Yes.
Is that on the...
You use a knife or the scissors?
That's on the outer part of the arm.
That's your forearm. That's your forearm part right here. That open space, it's right
That's
here.
Where the spines go, right?
The blades?
I meant right across here. This...
Yeah, the middle part, the middle spine, that's where your blades go.
Okay.
And that open space is just the back part of the foam. Yes, sir. Sure, no problem. Not a problem. Let me get you a piece of foam. Now, this is a additional workshop, so it's an additional $5. You did? I'm sorry. Don't mind me. I just...
Let me have some
thing. They already hit the table.
Cool. Don't mind me. What do y'all think?
This is Marcus. I'm Mike.
Jason.
Marcus has a good name.
But you get these are from Harbor Freight, so these are about $15-$20 for a pack of four. In fact, four will get you a couple of pieces of armor.
Dang,
suits.
If you want,
so it's about $20. Unfortunately, you have manufactured these
backs. Oh,
so it was wrong with the other ones?
It had a lot of bubbles in them, so it's just more money. It's just deeper perfection. Actually, no, I'm sorry, this is a good one. I'll give you one
that has. Give me a bad one. Give me
this one has the bubbles.
Give me a terrible, terrible one.
So now, you can get these from Academy, Depot, Lowe's, or Freight.
Yeah, I'll come in packs of four.
Between four and six.
Okay.
They're about $20 each.
Okay.
You'll see one side has a rigid side. So these are used for children's rooms, so safety mats,
right, okay.
Or for gyms, weight on them because they're pretty high density.
Oh, they are, yeah.
Now, we have one smooth side, and we have one rigid side. This is a pattern. The ones you get in the Caddy Home Depot don't have the raised kind of metal grate look to it.
Yeah.
This is more of a carbon fiber weave look.
Right.
So that kind of like it. So what I suggested to him is templates here to make a Batman style comic.
Okay.
Use this to cut your main template from, and we'll use some other smaller foam to cut your other pieces from. So, is this going to be for both?
For both.
Yeah. Cool.
It'll be interesting on the other side. This chair here,
though, so it's going to help me. Yeah, do a nice straight edge. Now, normally, I came up with simple templates. It's very, very, very simple. It's scalable. I basically just put it in my printer and have it scaled. I also use projector sometimes, put it on the wall, and then scale it. chest. Everybody has a different size forearm.
Right.
Now this might be more than size. I don't know. Maybe it might be too small. If it is, we have larger sizes.
So I just wrap it around.
Normally, I would bring. But I could bring one as just a tape measure.
Okay.
You can measure it yourself. You get a packet of measurement.
And
for me, I just like that.
Okay.
Use one on one hand to measure your wrist.
Right.
And see, so my hand is about a 11.5 inches. So that would be about like not there to sit right.
Okay.
So I would say measure like that, and come over here and measure. This is your wrist. So measure there. There you go. So now put your hand straight out. Put your feet like that. See, now you'll see this one's gonna be a little bit loose on you, so that's okay.
Okay.
And if it is too loose, we can always add an extra piece of foam right here. And it'll make it sit flush and it'll move.
Okay.
So we'll take, you can have that one. Now, so this is a Batman style prompt, so you're gonna have wooden blades and then straight edge. Sure.
Okay.
Now, how this works, you wanna cut this out with a straight edge and a sharp utility knife. Cut this out right here. We'll transfer this to here. Cut that out. Come back to this, we'll cut these inside pieces out. And once you do that, we'll use the thinner foam. Put that on the thinner foam, put the thinner foam on top of the thicker foam. You'll have a two-layer effect.
Okay, so this doesn't, this stays on for the
for this part, it'll stay on.
Okay.
Just because it just gives a little more stability to the thing, so it doesn't look like material transfer.
Okay, sure, yeah.
So it's a two-piece template. So this whole piece on here, just this right here, we'll go to the thinner foam.
Okay.
The blades right here. Then the thicker foam again, and then the straps will be on the thinner foam.
Okay.
The straps we're going to do is going to hot glue. We'll hot glue, you're just going to cut them out to one side. On the other side, we're going to attach these like Velcro tabs. And we'll basically just put two Velcro straps for the easy secure.
Right.
It's a very, very basic, simple template.
Yeah.
That gives you an idea of how things are made today.
Just
practice. This is
what
the simple thing possible. They're just straps because they're glued here. This is secured on your
finger. Okay. Okay.
And these are the blades you can cut out, or we can glue them down on the spine.
Okay, cool.
So they look like Batman will
right.
Pull you right there. So y'all can use the same blades for both of them.
Okay.
For you, probably going to be, like I ran out of these 75 degrees. Kind of the larger ones now. This, probably the smallest one I have right now is probably this right here. It's probably,
do I measure right here?
Mm-hmm. It's way too big.
Yeah, that's probably 10 and a half.
But it might be okay because of the thickness of the foam. You always say this is on the outside, the thickness of the foam will cut away from that, so it won't be too tight.
Right.
So you can still keep this, take this home, and you can scan it in and shrink it down if you'd like to make something.
Okay.
So we'll give you that, and y'all both can share the blades and the straps too.
Cool.
There's that. We'll get y'all some foam. You can do that. I just don't like when you do that, you're transferring that safety stuff to the foam. And usually when you're cutting, unless you want to work in reverse and cut from the back side, I just prefer intense because it makes tiny little holes. There's no sticky things added to the foam that could potentially ruin the paint job later on.
What were you talking about?
Spray marker?
Spray
marker?
Okay. You usually do something like Super 77. You
take the top edge.
Yes, that would be 3M Super 77.
Yes, very good. Spray.
Used the right way, it's an easy takeoff. Used the wrong way, it will never come off, and that's what they use for your carpet. No. That's what they use it for carpet, where they put vinyl with carpet on top of it.
Yeah.
Just Super 77, Super 77.
Wait for it, yeah. I guess you have to wait till it gets stacked a little bit.
That's a good. I used to try to stick on the back part of my carpet in the back of my van.
Yeah, me too. My very
first
car
is really that doesn't work.
All right,
because the problem is the foam that they use officially is Webby Stick, which is Super 77. Doesn't fail. The adhesive doesn't fail. The foam does. So only by spraying more,
it's
just
going to keep on that.
So here's y'all two pieces of foam. You have to take
sorry.
The four.
Cool.
And this is a cutting surface, so you don't cut on the cutting carpet.
Okay.
So you take the two pieces and you cut on top of this to make sure you don't cut anything into the carpet.
Okay.
Just that.
All right. So, great. We don't pin this.
And here's a straight edge for me. I'm going to change out these knives. So we're using real knives here, so be careful.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them might have stone.
Where's
all of the retractable blades everybody's using right now, so I have to give you mine. This is the one I use at home.
Okay, sweet.
Yo, a moment.
Yes.
Have y'all seen Chris or know where he is?
I don't know who Chris is.
The guy who's running Cosplay Chefs?
I don't know Cosplay Chefs or anybody named Chris.
Alright, so
sorry.
Oh crap.
So it's coming next, after this?
Shoot. Okay. Where is
then?
You know, that's a load.
Alright.
Yeah, this is a total lot of time.
I've already been sleeping.
In this room?
No, it's kind of hot.
Going by fast. So this is the one I use. I kind of like the exposed blade ones.
Mm-hmm.
They're a little more dangerous, but they last a lot.
Oh, that one doesn't retract.
No, it's permanently out.
No,
but this is a nice blade than that.
Put the pins in the template so that it holds it in place.
Well, just anywhere?
I would put it on the lines because you're going to use it also
and
to mark those
the
inside lines.
Once you cut them out, if you want to, you can actually cut the templates out with scissors and make it a little easier, a little quicker.
Okay.
If this is a big template, then you would want to cut it out with that. Here's a straight edge.
You want it?
But, and here is a marker. Here's your two pieces of foam with the cutting foam underneath. And then once you have your templates cut out, pick your pins and just pin it down.
Okay.
And then you can transfer it over with your magic marker. And then you can go back, pick your template off, and you can cut it out.
So how do we transfer over?
What you're going to do when you cut, I'm sorry, when you cut these out, cut that out,
yes.
You'll have that, and you transfer
it again.
Basically, okay. Right here, pins, you trace it out.
Around. Okay.
And you cut it out.
Okay.
Super simple.
Okay. This is the one just a very, very broken.
There's much more complicated techniques and methods out there. This is the quickest and easiest.
They just have to put meals up at
home. Let me see what you got.
Where's your name?
Jason,
Mike. Thanks.
Mm-hmm. Cool. We got the blades. And what you need here now is to do the. Now, this is red. But I'll tell you how you're going to seal these and paint them so they all look uniform color.
Do you have any more bad pieces?
Yes. I give them a bad piece to cut them.
Oh.
Yeah, they should have three pieces.
The sharing?
Yeah, the sharing one cutter. Because I only have one cutting tool. So, where's your template at? Now, what you want to do now is cut these inside pieces out. Very carefully, just cut them out. Then you can take this and put it on here and transfer it over to the place. Then once that's cut out, you should be able to put it right on top.
It's a weird if you're there half on this.
What's that?
It's a weird extra strands right there. Just be cut out of this as well. Sure enough. Next thing you need to do is cut out these little pieces. You basically cut this line here on both sides. So all you're going to have left over is this big little rim right here. Once you have that done, put it on here. And you put it on here. You cut it out. And you cut this little, you'll have the whole thing. You cut the little part and this out on here. So the thin foam, you'll then put to here. We're going to glue it on here. Okay? And then you also need to cut your straps out of this stuff here.
Speak up.
I do have a microphone.
Speak softly.
I think the one I have this big one here, which you can use up here. Unfortunately, I didn't bring enough. How's everybody doing out there?
Pretty good.
Yeah, it's pretty easy, right? It's a little time consuming.
Yes.
Yep.
The inside cuts are a little harder. I do, but this one's not the sharpest. Let me try that one this morning. Okay. Yeah, no problem. Sweet. It's a little bit early in the morning. I'm gonna read. Is it saved? And I can save it off your page, right?
You can share it directly from our page.
Yeah, I've told a lot of people to be shared on my page. They're probably going, if I don't see it on this page.
You could probably just go ahead and see if you can share it right now. Direct share.
Can you do that with the live?
I don't know.
I don't think you can.
Try. You never know until you try.
I don't like that.
Well, if you have a. You have the app that goes down directly to your page.
Well, I don't use crap phones.
Well, you can use your phone too. Download the app. The meat.
Oh, you said he needed to have apple.
No, I didn't. I even told you after you walked over there. I said you use your phone too. After you gave me crap about having an
app. I got my phone number. Right, man.
Download the Amiibo app. And we'll switch it over to your site. Amiibo.
Make sure you zoom in on my disconcerting look at you.
Right now, you know where the hell you're at. There you go.
As you convict yourself, go back to your template and cut the little square shapes out. And so you're going to have basically just the rim outline. Give me 1 second, I'm going to come out there and double check here, make sure everybody's doing well. Mevo, you said?
Yeah, M-E-V-O. And then once I stop, you can direct, show the other one directly out.
Here, Mevo weight loss and fitness. I think my phone's trying to tell me something. Mevo or Mevo?
Mevo, M-E-V-O.
Yeah, that's actually what it's called.
Maybe it is on the app.
Yeah.
Try live stream.
Sorry, you got plenty of phone to work with.
Yeah. Try live stream. Yeah.
Just the phone.
That's fine. You know, if you want to make this more of a curved piece, it's up to you. Because that kind of angle is kind of harder for a beginning level template. So that looks pretty good to me. I would say make a sharp cut here to here, but you can make this kind of a rounded. This might be a little easier for your wrist than the bend of your wrist. The sharp edges won't hurt as much. So that looks good. I would say go ahead and cut this out, and then we can work on cutting this middle piece out.
Let's say, so the next step after we cut the gauntlet and three spikes out.
You can get your thinner foam. And any color, because once you seal the paint, it'll all look the same. No, because we're inside, we don't have to do that. And I try to get this to be a 2 hour class. If we had 2 hour class, I probably should have to do it and bring it to the rock and stuff outside.
Right. Okay, so the inner squares and the two straps.
Now the inner squares, once you this part here, these parts of the inner squares, just toss them out.
Oh.
You don't really need them. You just leave them in there because it makes it easier for the template and it's not all flip and flop. You know what I mean? So these inner squares, you can keep them, but we toss them out. Once you cut them out, you're going to take this part right here. Transfer to that.
Okay.
This is going to be on top of the bigger form. It's going to have two, three, a layer.
So it's reverse layers, recess.
There you go. That's what I was looking at earlier, recess. So you're going to have this bone recessed underneath this right here.
Okay, I was thinking in reverse. That's looking that on top.
Because thinner ones will be on top. The thinner ones on top. The thinner one on top, the thicker one on the bottom. And what he's doing, he's cutting the thicker one with the carbon fiber side. Or it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Same on both sides. He's doing the carbon fiber side, so you can see the carbon fiber.
Right, I'm doing it too.
I think it's pretty cool with that, man.
Yeah, it seems to be maybe a little small.
Creative writing.
Well, that's pretty good. Yeah. Yeah, because when you do a template like this, you cut out your arms, it's right on the knee, it's right on the ground. But you gotta think about it, it's like this. That's 3/8, so that's 6/8, so 3/4 inch, you're taking away from this
amount.
So for me, it'll be only a touch.
Right.
Fairly. So, and we're gonna have quite a detail, so we'll help. Once you get glued on there, yeah, we're gonna heat it up and make it that. And both sides are used too. Now, I brought my Dremel, but let's go use this to create a mess. But I would use my Dremel to make those little sharpies.
Right, because the edges were kind of hard to cut from the bone.
And that's why I would use these straight edges,
right here,
and 45 degree angle on them.
Does that have to do a kind of sawing action to get through that foam with that straight edge?
Yeah, it's foam. Yes,
in the big one.
You're good to go into that, and when we get to your templates, cut the middle squares out. Once you get those middle squares taken away, what you have left, put it on here. Do the same thing, transfer it on there, cut it out, glue it on top of here. And then we'll stay and get your straps cut out here.
Right.
Because of this much. Do you want me to see if we can make a spot right here for you to sit up in here?
Oh, man, it's four. It's okay.
You sure?
Yeah, we can definitely make a spot.
Would you make some spot for you so you can sit there? Make it a little easier.
I've got the cutting gun anyway, so. Todd, can you see our knife for 2 seconds? Just some of my men go all the way there.
He's got his finished.
Let me just use the chair. Thank you.
No, I was saying he had his finished.
That's quick. Perfect.
I'm just selling your stuff off.
Huh?
Selling your stuff off.
So this is how it's going to be. Now, you want the smooth side, or do you want more than carbon fiber side?
I still need it on scratch, but I'm working on cutting out the insides right now.
Right. Something else. What you want to do is put glue.
I don't
think so. This one's ready to go. I like this one better because it's smaller. This one kind of
squishes
too much. So this is probably good. I don't know, this is a brand new one, so I would say use this one. Just do a small line all the way around. And very carefully. Whichever side you like the best. Remember, when you get to cutting your overlays, you want to use a thinner foam. Right, get that? How about you guys in front? You guys ever cut it out of the paper stuff? Yeah, I printed out some regular paper. It's nice to make templates out of paper cardstock if you can. I should have printed out of it. But you want to, that's probably what I would. So you want to take this and trace it on here. You can still kind of salvage that or put it on here. here,
just like
here.
What's that guy's name?
Oh, Rehar.
Now, if you want to change it up,
Rehar.
Rehar.
He's the one that has the cannon.
However you want to, this is kind of a weird thing. But the template, how it works is everybody, that trench over here, which here you can put that trench over. Okay. But you want to change it up to your own thing? It's an overlay. Mm-hmm. It just gives it a two-layer template. And what I've told other people, it's hard to fire Batman style or whatever. It gives a different texture. So this is a smooth texture. So you get a little more complicated look to it. You know what I mean?
Use the big ones, they're cooler.
But it's your own thing. However you want to do it.
Hey, do little leaf cuts and turn it into something like a computer use.
My next I saw a laser cutter that cuts a home laser cutter that can cut this foam. Glowforge, yeah.
Yeah, I ordered it.
Did you?
Yeah.
I have a buddy of mine who ordered one too.
It'll be around in December.
I know, but it'll be much more expensive than it was the initial price.
Yeah.
I want that very much.
If your buddy gives you his code, you can save $100 and he will save $100.
Well, right
now, until I will basically pay the extra money and know that it will show up. That'll be there as a reason. Right now, not knowing that it's gonna happen.
For you, you cut it out correctly, but I would say you probably want to use it on the thinner.
Okay.
I'm sorry, I didn't tell you that earlier.
Yeah, fine.
Because, let's see here. Actually, you cut it out
the wrong way.
Correct.
The reverse.
Now this is this part right here is supposed to be one solid piece.
Oh, okay.
So that's all you cut down, just to tell you earlier. So you can still see this. You still have a perfectly template, so you can still cut it out of those corners.
Okay.
You get another piece. You get another piece.
No problem.
One piece here, which you did here, correct, but on the thinner stuff.
Ah, okay.
The thinner stuff will go on top of here, and you'll have a two-layer effect.
Gotcha.
Okay?
Sorry. Thanks.
No problem. Sorry about that.
No problem. I did this first.
I think skeletonized.
No.
That's correct. Can you use your, you got a blade one? Did somebody else need a blades template? That's somebody else said that. You said it. Oh, you already done.
Did you like that? I have a piece of red you can use.
Okay.
Just
need to move over there.
Good job. Oh, you can't see you. Yeah. All right. So, we're going to be down. You have to put it on there pretty well. The hot glue takes a while to stick, so it's good. So I'm going to start forming it now, making it curve. And hopefully I won't blow up a circuit. Hot glue gun. I mean, this is our heat gun. So warm up a little bit. So you can already smell the smell. I would suggest
it smells burning my skin.
So it smells like, well, this is because I've had stuff in here, so it's probably burning me. But I think it's very, very hot, so you want to be careful with it. And you can start seeing the foam change shape a little bit, the texture of it will change, and what it's doing. Those little microscopic bubbles that are in there, you can see them in the mouth, just kind of expanding them and closing them all up. So you'll start seeing it change color a little bit. Or you can see the little change, see it? That makes it start to get a little warm. So if you put it over one spot, you're going to burn it. Which is just, you told me it's really nice and gentle over a couple of passes. You want to do the other side as well. You want to do both sides. Now the hot glue, it reacts to heat. So if you heat it up too much, you're going to lose the glue up and it'll start coming off.
How you got the helmet to do that.
Yeah, so I made the helmet out of this stuff, just thinner stuff. See what I'm doing here? Starts to look like it is now?
Yeah, that's the other stuff. I'm doing it completely wrong. I'll do it my way.
Be careful.
I think it's gonna look that, but it's completely not what he said.
See how it changes color?
This is gonna be the inside of the...
Texture change on it.
Ask him, can I do it completely wrong?
This thinner foam's gonna be on the inside?
It's gonna be on the outside. I'll show you. You see this real quick? Just like this, see? So it's gonna go on top. So, you can use black and black, doesn't matter. But you, you're using, you're cutting the long stuff out. This right here, it pops these out. You're gonna use it.
Could I have a blue piece for mine, please?
No.
And I'm doing mine completely backwards from what you said.
It's okay, no, no. You do, this is your thing. You do what you want. You're okay for the phone, you do what you want. But, I'm gonna show you how to, now briefly show you, we're not gonna have time, but how to seal it and paint it so it's all one uniform color.
Right. Is there a way to make these edges a little
nicer? Smoother? Yes. And unfortunately, I'm not gonna be able to cover that here because it uses a Dremel, which I brought my
book
and I'll show you. I have a Dremel at home.
Yeah, I didn't know.
This is the Dremel I have. It has a snake
adapter. I've never used it, but.
It's got the snake adapter.
Yeah.
So you can get in there, do the nooks and crannies, and get it sanded down.
Okay.
So I would suggest getting this attached. Yeah, Dremel's only $25 to $30
I think I have one, actually. My dad's given me so many tools, I don't even know.
Yes, sir. Okay, now you've already transferred this to your phone. You got the thick foam out of this piece. Okay, what you need to do is cut these inner pieces out.
I'm going to go get the other piece.
Okay, like you. Yeah. See that? That's what you need to do on that thinner foam. And the thinner foam is right there on the chair. Any color doesn't matter because we're going to have, I'll show you how to go home and seal it and paint it. And
you're
going
to have to take a little bit of the card, though.
You want to get both sides too. See now if you got a little bit close?
Okay. I am standing.
Yeah, it's okay, you're good.
I have to announce the states.
You get both sides? Now just see how it's flattened out a little bit. You should relax.
It's like this.
Okay. Push it over. Is there a something after this?
Cosplay shows.
What?
I don't think that's
Cosplay shows.
Because
actually, I don't think that's pretty. Not really. Yeah. Chess. All right. Cosplay. So is that why I got about 20 minutes left
before we start cleaning up? People who are cosplaying are the actual chess pieces. They have that huge chessboard out there.
That's a
big
cool.
Game of human chess.
That is cool.
That was fun.
That's
keeping track of everyone.
See who's
a bunch of martial artists.
It's
like that bloodsport.
See these two lines? Cut those. And come back.
Yeah.
For another pin.
There you go. That's about as good as it gets. Let's get some internal structure. I'm kind of do the image. Look at this from here. Final curve. It's this. Because you're heating a foam. Now, when you're heating a foam, I would suggest wearing a mask. There's no rules.
Okay.
There's no rules.
And they are mostly unionized jobs.
See how we look at the results.
Once you're doing it,
And so where's your template at? You still need to do the outside as well. Come back on there.
Do you have the side of the
You're doing very well. You did a great job up there. But now you need to trace the outside. So use your template or your pins, so put it on there perfectly. That's when the pins are nice. Put it on there, and so walk move. So.
Oh, I cut out these middle parts. That's what you did?
So belts for a living. I can make curtains for a living. I can sew pillows for a living.
Alterations.
I can work in alteration shops, and there's hundreds of them in Houston.
Yes. Look at you. All right.
We'll come and do the little gluing station right there.
Wherever you want. I would say. So you're. Are you left hand on this one or are you on your right arm? Okay. So I would say you can use your hand this way. So you can just grab it.
Pretty impressive.
You see the vivid.
Yeah. You know,
People watching, which is not
my problem. Yeah, you mark what you want to mark. But I can cut the same pieces out while you're using my dog. Cut out here.
As it can be, like, as with the certain way to block it.
Yeah, this is what mine's going to look like. Completely different.
But it's good for making stuff look like because it has such a good smooth side, but you have to pair it really good.
I was really struggling to keep the edges straight.
So you just kind of,
if you can give me a straight edge, it would help.
Yeah. I had a straight edge right here. You can always use this one right here. It's a big one.
It doesn't work on the curves, but for anything that's straight, use it.
Yeah. So you just get your, just attach it to there, retrace it, the outside and inside. So once you're done with that, take this off and cut everything out. Okay? Now this is a little harder to cut because you got a little thinner sides. So you gotta make sure your cuts are pretty smooth.
Yes.
Okay. And here's some more pins if you want. There you go. Just be careful, sure. Oh, see this?
Ooh. Not bad. Oh, that would be so pretty. Okay.
That's okay.
Have fun.
Sorry.
So don't be shy.
So now what we're going to do here, you can call it cold form. Just go like this. You just want to play with it. A lot of people use their legs because it has a nice little bend to your leg. You can kind of go like this. But what I do is just use your hands, get your fingernails in there. So this side's going to be hidden, so you can dig in there if you want. Just start shaping it around. Go like this. You can hold it a little bit. It's got a little shape already. Now we're going to keep forming it. You got to fold on the hot setting. You got to be careful with this. I'm going to start on the inside first. Now you can see the shape change of it. See that? It's closing all the microscopic pores that are on the foam. It's basically expanding the foam and sealing it again.
Is it already 11 o'clock?
No, 9
not yet.
Okay.
But they have to empty out the chairs. Is it okay if they start bringing it back around?
Yeah, that's fine. Okay. Don't mind if we can run over. That'd be great. Appreciate it. So you can see how I relaxed again.
Yeah.
But it's still gonna remember that whole form of shape you just did. So you get that and do another side. Now since we use hot glue, it's gonna react to that pretty well. Now, what you did, you did little beads of it. You like did drop. The problem is that, with a thinner foam like this, that's why I prefer to use barge. Unfortunately, we can't use barge in here because we're inside. Now, since it's a little warm, you can shape it a little bit more now. Just like this. Just kind of hold it there for a little while. It'll start cooling down. See, when you use the bead like that, it'll move because it heats up that glue. Barge is a contact cement. So it doesn't leave a bead, it leaves a real nice smooth finish to it and sticks permanently. That's the one downfall of the hot glue. You start hard heat forming it, so it can kind of come off on you. But we can't use barge here. What else am I going to pass out? In a bathroom. So there you go. So you can basically put it on your arm right now. Mm-hmm. You can still play with it more. Because it's still a little bit warm until it cools down. And you come back over there, you can glue your blades on and your straps.
Well, looks like I already glued my
blades. It's okay. No, that's all right. You can still do it. You've got to be a little more careful when you finish. So I would say I'd start on this inside first. As I was telling everybody else, about hurting. You can start to see, you'll see it change, like shininess kind of thing.
Yeah.
That means it starts to heat up and close all the pores, or expand the pores on the two. But it's starting to heat up. You don't want to keep it on one spot, you're going to burn it. It's like it's hot.
See, I'm not good
for removing paint off of it.
Yeah.
So, just real nice and gentle back and forth, and on top as well. Just, you got to be careful on here, because it's hot glue. Use a meat, it'll make it loose again. So, don't go crazy on the blades. Plus, that's the middle part, that doesn't bend. So, over here.
Oh, that is true.
All the inside. Okay. And when you're done, shut it off.
As long as it's good, it's not a minute.
Say a good way to do it. You can grab it like this, like you're rolling a piece of paper.
I'll get your butt parts cut out for you.
Now, since you already have your blades on there, you'd be able to, other people's you'd be able to roll all the way around. But see, since you have blades on, we don't want to mess those up, so we're just going to do one side. Come over here and do the other side. A little bit more of a shape.
See,
I would heat it up some more, but since you have your blades on, it makes it a little more difficult.
Yeah.
But that's enough of a bend to get it to work.
Mm-hmm.
You can glue on your straps.
Can you do that with a regular hair dryer?
Doesn't get as hot.
Okay.
I tried.
I did that with my first project with all the foam. All the screw creating the portal got it from portal.
With the hot, with the
yes.
blow dryer?
Yeah. One of the things is like those curvy parts.
When you have the strap, you're going to fix it. So I did that.
You should, what? Let's go over here and use
I don't have any pictures of it. I think on this one,
I didn't know if I needed to put the straps in.
Yes.
On yet.
It makes a lot easier.
I didn't know if I needed to put the.
Well, the other thing that
kind of makes it harder when you do it is you kind of want to manhandle a little bit. And since we don't have any like internal structure or any like recessed holes and set the blades, and normally I would probably put a wooden peg in there, drill a hole through the blades, put it in there, gives a little more structure in case you bump. Because if con, you're going to bump on the things. Especially with hot glue's not the strongest.
Right.
I would still use barge, but even barge, if somebody comes up to you, they hit you hard enough. Or if you're playing around and somebody has a weapon, hits it, whatever you're doing to shoot, it'll knock it off. So we can cold form it first, and have a little more of a memory shape.
Oh.
Kind of hold it a little bit. Do the same thing on the other side.
Oh,
so you get a little cold form
right
there. See, it's got a little bit of a shake.
Right.
It'll, when you heat it up, it's going to relax, but it still should remember that shape. And once you heat it up, outside and inside and outside, do the same thing. Roll it up.
So just heat it up and then do it again?
Yes. Now when you heat it up, always start heating it up. Now when you get turned it as a low and high setting. Either one works, but for the shape, for the time constraints we have, do it on high. Now the problem with high, it gets real hot.
The bow is actually.
five to three. So you want to just real quickly go over, and you'll start seeing it change the texture.
Really?
Color will change. Will change. If you get it over, leave it over, it'll change too much, and you will burn it.
I'm just like trying to roll it at the same time, just keep it up there.
Yeah, let's do this. Let's pull it.
Whatever side you like, you matches up for. There you go. Right there, just like that. And once you do that, we'll start forming and shaping and giving you the curve. Yeah. Let's take a look at them. Did you hot glue one of the side filters on each side? It comes a little bit back, sticking back to it, but it's not the greatest. I would still add a little bit of dab of hot glue for the t-shirt to do it again. A little dab of hot glue.
A little further.
See,
can
you get it up right?
I curled it once.
All the way around? Hold it for a little bit. Get a nice little grip to it. It sounds pretty rigid. That's good enough, because that's all you need is close that much.
Right.
So I would say put it on your arm and see how it fits.
Huh?
I have a drawing.
Well,
that says fits pretty well. So we can come back over here, we can get your blades, and you get your straps cut out as well.
I got straps too. So we'll have straps and we'll have your
that's up to you. What we can do is with extra pieces of foam, we can slide a piece of foam here in the middle, and so it'll make it stand off the wrist a little bit and make it a little bit more comfortable actually. And we can make it like that. How big is this? That's easy what I do at home.
I only have one hand.
a foot like this. On your phone, just cut out a 2-inch strip like this, all the way down. Hot glue on it, and it should be able to fit, probably fit pretty tightly. Before you do that, you might want to go into your, no, actually you want to do it afterwards. Do a little thing in the middle, come back, we'll put your Velcro caps on.
Oops, sorry.
Yes.
Somebody that was like,
thank you very much.
Yeah.